William is 5 years old. He has blue eyes and light brown hair. His parents and friends call him Billy. Billy wears overalls and a striped sweater. Billy sits at the dining table while his mother prepares breakfast for him. His dad kisses him on the forehead and joins him at the table, pouring himself some coffee and eating bread with butter.
"How was our sweet Billy today?" asks Dad.
"I'm excited. I'm going to go play soccer with Steve and Judy," replies Billy, swinging his legs from the chair as he waits for his breakfast.
"That's great. Remember, soccer's a team sport. If you don't play as a team, you cannot win."
"Toasted bread with cheese and jam. My favorite. Thanks, Mom. You're the best," says Billy as he jumps out of his chair to hug his mom, who smiles at him.
As Billy's mother talks to his dad, Billy starts to think of all the fun he will have today and gets lost in his thoughts.
"Billy, my boy, close your mouth or a fly might fly in it," says Billy's dad,
who starts laughing as soon as he tells the joke. Billy's mother grins as she hears the bad joke. Billy, hearing his dad's joke, laughs too and gets back to eating his yummy breakfast. As his family finishes their breakfast, the doorbell rings.
"I'll get it,"
says Billy, as he hops out of his chair and runs to the door. He knows who it is. As Billy opens the door, he is lifted by a boy almost twice his size. Nice. It's his 10-year-old nephew, George. George lives on the second floor of the same building, and Billy really looks up to George.
"How's our Billy?"
says George as he tickles him. Billy laughs and giggles.
"Are you coming to play with us today?"
asks Billy, still in George's arms.
"I can't. I have to go swimming. Besides, kids your age can't beat me at anything," says George as he puts Billy down.
"What about the time I won you in Monopoly?"
"Hello, Dave and Jennifer," says George.
"Hello, kiddo,"
reply Mr. and Mrs. Sean all together. George turns to Mrs. Sean and says,
"Mom says she's sorry that we weren't able to come to your birthday yesterday as we had to go out of town."
"It's okay, Georgie. I have heard." "Would you like some toasted bread and jam?" asks Mrs. Sean.
"Thanks, but I really need to go swimming," replies George.
Billy sees George take something out of his bag.
"What's that?"
asks Billy. George is holding a book.
"This is for you, Mr. William,"
jokes George.
"William, kid. Hey, that's my name,"
reads Billy, but he can't seem to read the last words.
"William Kidd, The Life of a Pirate. It's the story of a famous pirate named William. Is it your story, William?"
asks George jokingly. Billy is confused. He replies,
"But I've never been a pirate, and I'm 5.
"Well, you can be, Billy. You just have to imagine it," replies George.
George looks at his watch, then turns to Billy and his parents.
"Okay, I should be going now, or I'll be late. Bye, everyone,"
says George as he runs out of the door. Billy begins to think of how life would be as a pirate. He is still holding the book George just gave him. Billy opens the book and sees ships, pirates, animals, and all sorts of treasure. Now Billy wants to become a pirate.
"Georgie said all I have to do is imagine,"
Billy says to himself. His mother waves at Billy, who is still lost in his imagination.
"What are you thinking about, Billy?"
asks Mrs. Sean.
"Mom, can I be a pirate?"
asks Billy. Mrs. Sean is surprised by Billy's question.
"Well, can I ask you why you want to be a pirate?" asks Mrs. Sean.
"They have ships, parrots, and treasures," replies Billy.
Mrs. Sean does not want Billy to frown, so she thinks of an idea and says,
"Why don't you go get ready, and we'll make paper ships to put in the fountain?"
Billy is delighted.
"Really?"
asks Billy.
"My ship's name will be Adventure, just like William Kidd,"
adds Billy as he runs off to his room while Mrs. Sean grins. Billy is still thinking about treasure when he gets an idea. He goes to his mother's room and takes out a necklace from her dressing table drawer. He hides it in his pocket. As he comes out of this room, his father kisses him goodbye on the forehead and leaves. Mommy does not always go anywhere because she works from home on her computer. Billy and his mom go outside. In front of his building is a soccer field, fountain, pond, and small playground. To the right, a soccer sports house is being built. Billy is filled with joy to see his friend. He says,
"It's good. Good to see you, Steve. And you, Mrs. Chandler."
"It's good to see you too, Billy," says Mrs. Chandler as she pats Billy on the head. "Okay, kids, today we'll make boats and have them," starts Mrs. Sean, but Billy interrupts her.
"Thanks, Mom, but I want to do something else first."
Mrs. Sean is surprised, but says, "Okay, go and play with your friends." Mrs. Sean and Mrs. Chandler go to sit on a bench nearby and have a chat.
"I see Billy the Stutter is back," jokes a kid.
"Cut it out, Sam," says Steve.
It's okay, Steve,"
replies Billy, while some kids laugh at him. Billy is confused about why the kids are laughing.
"Hello, Billy and Steve,"
says Judy, as she shakes her hands with both Billy and Steve.
"Hey, guys, let's play pirates today," says Billy.
Steve and Judy are surprised, and Judy asks, "How are we going to do that?"
"Georgie said you can imagine being a pirate, and that's what I want to do today,"
replies Billy without stuttering, which surprises both Steve and Judy even more. Steve is playing with a soccer ball.
"How are we going to do that?"
asks Steve, who is curious about what Billy has been thinking.
"I want to do a treasure hunt," replies Billy.
Hearing Billy say treasure surprises Sam, who becomes curious. "What treasure?" thinks Sam. So he starts spying on the three friends. Judy and Steve are confused, but Billy shows them his brother's necklace and says,
"This will be our treasure."
"Where did you get that?" asks Judy.
"It's my mom's," says Billy. "Don't worry, we'll bury it, make a treasure map, and tomorrow, early in the morning, we dig it up again."
Judy replies, "I don't know about," but she stops when Steve pinches her.
"What?"
Judy whispers in Steve's ear.
"Okay, let's do it, Billy,"
says Judy.
"No, today I am not Billy. Today I am William Kidd, the pirate," replies Billy.
"Aye, aye, Captain Kidd," says Steve, which makes Billy smile.
"Ahoy, Captain William,"
says Judy, to which Billy replies,
"Arr!"
The three laugh and start digging a hole in the field near the fountain. Sam is curious and watches them dig the hole. After digging the hole, the three kid pirates wrap the necklace in paper and bury it. The kids then draw a treasure map. They draw a small tree at the upper left part of the treasure map and draw a fountain at the bottom right. They then draw an X in the middle of the paper to mark the treasure. The kid pirates then go back to Mrs. Sean, sitting on the bench talking to her friend. They see Mrs. Sean has made 5 paper ships, 3 for the kids, 1 for Mrs. Chandler, and 1 for herself. "This one's for you, Captain William Kidd," says Mrs. Sean, as she hands Billy one of the paper ships. Billy is filled with joy as he sees "Adventure" written on the boat. As the kids play with the paper ships, Sam moves towards the spot where Billy, Steve, and Judy had dug the hole for their treasure. He digs up the hole, unwraps the necklace, and takes it for himself. He then fills the hole back up again.
"That'll teach them pirates,"
jokes Sam as he runs away with the necklace. The next day, Mrs. Sean asks Mr. Sean,
"David, have you seen my necklace? I can't find it anywhere."
"No, honey, I have not," replies Mr. Sean.
Billy stays quiet as he does not want his mom to worry.
"I'll return the necklace, Mom. Don't you worry,"
Billy is outside and has the treasure map in his pocket, and he waits for his friends to arrive. After a while, Billy sees Judy and Steve running towards him. Billy hugs Steve and Judy, then pulls out the treasure map.
"So let's see," says Judy as she looks at the map in Billy's hands.
As Billy and his friends try to figure out where their treasure is, their parents start talking to each other. Mrs. Sean asks,
"What are the kids up to? I haven't seen Billy so excited before."
Judy's mother replies,
"Well, they're doing some sort of treasure hunt."
"Oh, really?"
says Mrs. Sean. Now Sam arrives at the soccer ground, but sees he is too late. He hides behind the tree, which Billy had drawn on the treasure map, and waits. But he does not know what to do.
"What now?"
thinks Sam. He really wants to return the necklace. Billy and his friends dig the hole where the treasure is supposed to be, but they cannot seem to find it.
"Where is treasure?"
asks Billy. The kid pirates keep trying, but they just can't find their treasure. After some time, Mrs. Sean comes over to see what the kids are doing.
"What are my pirates doing?" asks Mrs. Sean.
"We can't find our treasure, Mom,"
says Billy. Billy's afraid to tell his mother he has lost her necklace, but his mother pats him on the back to comfort him. Mrs. Sean says,
"Don't be scared, Billy."
Mrs. Sean, now curious, asks, "What was this treasure, Billy?"
It was the necklace in your drawer,"
replies Billy. Mrs. Sean cannot believe what she has just heard. Mrs. Sean is now both disappointed and angry with Billy.
"William Sean, why did you take my necklace without my permission? I was asking for it this morning. Why didn't you tell me where it was?"
asks Mrs. Sean loudly. Tears come out of Billy's eyes as he hears his mom's loud voice. Sam feels bad for Billy. Mr. Sean, seeing Mrs. Sean's anger, whispers, "Go easy on Billy. He's just a kid."
I'm sorry, Mom. I just wanted to be a pirate,"
replies Billy, who is now crying. Seeing Billy cry, Mrs. Sean feels bad and starts searching for her necklace.
"Let's search for the necklace. If we find it, good. If we don't, I can always buy another one,"
says Mrs. Sean to comfort Billy, and they start looking for the necklace. Seeing this, all the others present also begin digging. All of a sudden, there are holes everywhere. As everyone searches for the necklace, Sam thinks of an idea. He remembers the paper ships that sank in the fountain, and so he runs to the fountain. He then puts the necklace beside Billy's ship. After searching a little longer, Mrs. Sean stops and says,
"Well, it seems we have lost our treasure, Billy. Don't worry, Billy. I'll get another necklace. Let's just go home, okay?"
"Hello, Billy,"
says Sam. Then he asks,
"I hear you made paper ships yesterday. Can I see yours?"
Billy looks at his mother's face, and then Billy and his mother walk towards the fountain. Now all Sam can do is hope that Billy or Mrs. Sean see the necklace. Billy sees his ship adventure, but he picks up something else instead. Billy looks at what he has picked up, and he is surprised. It's his mother's necklace. It's the treasure that he had lost. He has now found the lost treasure. Billy picks up his paper ship with his right hand and runs to his mother.
"I found your necklace, Mom!"
Mrs. Sean is filled with joy and hugs her son and says,
"Well done, Captain William Kidd."
Billy is relieved that he has found the necklace. He then shows Sam the ship. Sam pretends to be surprised.
I'm sorry, Mom. I should have,
apologizes Billy.
"It's okay, Billy, but remember, you can tell me anything, anytime, and always ask permission before you take things from people, okay?"
"Okay,"
replies Billy. After finding the treasure, Billy and his family say goodbye.